Welcome to free online classes of physics with Lambosa. So we are discussing regarding the electromagnetic wave, and earlier we studied how the electromagnetic waves can be produced, production of electromagnetic waves. So with the help of electrons, with the help of electric charge, we can produce electromagnetic waves. Then we studied the transverse nature of electromagnetic waves. So any electromagnetic wave consists time-varying electric and magnetic fields at right angles to each other, and both are perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. From that, it proves that electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. And then mathematical equation describing electromagnetic wave that we have studied. And finally, the characteristics, few important characteristics of electromagnetic waves, that also we discussed in the previous lecture. So now let us learn what is electromagnetic spectrum. So this electromagnetic spectrum is nothing but the arrangement, the orderly distribution of all the electromagnetic waves. Arrangement or sequential arrangement of electromagnetic waves according to their wavelengths or frequency in a different distinct region, such that the properties of each region are same, but properties of region to region different. Such orderly distribution or sequential arrangement of electromagnetic waves according to their wavelengths or frequency in the form of distinct group of different properties. That arrangement of electromagnetic waves is called electromagnetic spectrum. So this spectrum can be defined like this. The orderly distribution, that is sequential arrangement of electromagnetic waves according to their wavelengths or frequencies in the form of distinct groups having different properties. That arrangement or that distribution of electromagnetic waves are called electromagnetic spectrum. So let us, we will study the diagrammatical information regarding the electromagnetic spectrum. You can see in this diagram there are different regions or groups. In that first group, the electromagnetic waves are called as the gamma rays. In this second group, the electromagnetic waves are called as the X-rays, ultraviolet rays, infrared radiations, microwaves, radio waves. So in this case, that electromagnetic waves are arranged or they are orderly distributed according to their wavelength or frequencies. And we know that for any wave, frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional. A wave having shorter wavelength is having higher frequency, greater frequency. Both are inversely proportional. And frequency of wave decides its energy. So in this spectrum, in this diagram, all the electromagnetic waves are orderly distributed or sequentially arranged as per their wavelengths. You can see here, wavelengths are measured in meter. Gamma rays, या region मदे जा electromagnetic waves आहें, त्यांच्या वेवलेंथची रेंज 10 रेस्ट टू मायनस 13 मीटर टू 10 रेस्ट टू मायनस 11 मीटर. एक्सरेज ह्या रिजन मध्ये, ह्या ग्रुप मध्ये ज्या इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स आहेत त्यांच्या वेवलेंथ 10 रेस्ट टू मायनस 11 मीटर टू 10 रेस्ट टू मायनस 8 मीटर. सो फ्रॉम गॅमा रेज टू रेडिओ वेव्स, व्हाट इज हॅपनिंग? द वेवलेंथ्स आर इनक्रीजिंग. So from the right to left, gamma rays, x-rays, ultraviolet, infrared, microwave, radio waves. These are the distinct groups in which the electromagnetic waves are arranged or distributed according to their wavelengths. And from gamma rays to radio waves, if you shift from gamma rays to radio waves, then the wavelength of that electromagnetic waves are increasing. And if that electromagnetic waves are according to, are arranged or distributed according to the frequency, we will find that frequency is increasing from radio waves to gamma rays. Means radio waves ह्या distinct group मध्ये ज्या electromagnetic waves असतील त्यांच्या frequency सर्वात कमी, त्यांची energy सर्वात कमी. And the energy or frequency increases from radio waves to microwaves, infrared, visible region, ultraviolet, x-rays, gamma rays. म्हणजे gamma rays ह्या group मध्ये ज्या electromagnetic waves असतील they will have very high energy, very high frequency. So in this diagram there are total 7 regions, 7 distinct groups. First one is the gamma, x-ray, ultraviolet, and this one is the visible region. Then infrared, microwave, radio waves. So these are the 7 distinct groups in which the all electromagnetic waves are divided. And that electromagnetic waves are arranged or distributed according to their wavelengths or frequencies in the form of 7 distinct groups. And each group of electromagnetic waves have the different properties. At the same time, each region differs from another region from the method of production, method of detection, also uses of electromagnetic waves in different regions will be different. So in such arrangement of electromagnetic waves according to their wavelength or frequency in the form of 7 distinct groups, how many? 7 distinct groups having different properties. Each group is have different properties from the another group. Also the methods which produces the electromagnetic waves in each group are different. Production cha method, detection cha methods, ani uses of electromagnetic waves are different for the different regions or different groups. Such arrangement, such distribution of electromagnetic waves according to their wavelengths or frequency is called electromagnetic spectrum. So if we want to explain this electromagnetic spectrum, then we come to know that this electromagnetic spectrum contains different electromagnetic waves that differ from another wave in frequency and wavelength. If you see this region which is the visible region, then the electromagnetic waves in that visible region have the wavelength range, you can see here, nanometer, the wavelengths are expressed in nanometer. And in visible region, there are 7 different colors, which are arranged in the order of violet to red. Then in that visible region, the electromagnetic waves having the violet color are having 400 nanometer wavelength. And that wavelength is increasing up to red color. Electromagnetic waves having the red color. The waves of red color having the wavelength 750 nanometer. And if that wavelengths are expressed in angstrom unit, then electromagnetic waves for the violet color will have 4000 angstrom wavelength. And red color will have 7500 angstrom wavelength. So in visible region, wavelength increases from violet color to red color. So this is how the electromagnetic waves are arranged according to their wavelengths or frequency, sequential arrangement. So this electromagnetic spectrum is divided into seven main parts, seven main regions. So major regions of the electromagnetic spectrum are, first one is the gamma rays or gamma radiations, whose wavelength is shorter but energy is highest. Minimum wavelength cha electromagnetic waves gamma rays, gamma region madhe astat, pan highest frequency cha electromagnetic waves gamma region madhe mithi lagla. So gamma radiation is the first major region, then second one is the x-rays, third one is the ultraviolet radiations, and fourth one is the visible region, visible light you can say. Fifth one, infrared radiations. Sixth one is the microwave, and seventh is the radio waves. These are the seven main regions of electromagnetic spectrum, and each of that region have different properties. The electromagnetic waves representing each region has different properties, different methods of production, different methods of detection, and different uses for each region. Now, seventh one is the radio waves. See here, once again the same spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum, having seven major regions, and electromagnetic waves in each region having different wavelengths from the electromagnetic waves in the another region. So the sources that produces these waves and detectors that detects them are different for different regions. Means electromagnetic waves in gamma rays and electromagnetic waves in x-rays, the sources that produces them are different. Means electromagnetic waves in gamma region and x-ray region are produced by different sources, and also the detectors that detecting them are also different. So from the region to region the sources are differing and the detectors are also different. At the same time, the properties of electromagnetic waves are different in different regions, and uses of electromagnetic waves are also different for different regions. So as there are seven major regions of electromagnetic spectrum, the sources that produces them will be divided into seven types. There will be seven types of sources, there will be seven types of detectors, and also the uses of that electromagnetic waves will be divided into again seven types. So uses of radio waves is different from the uses of microwaves. And in this spectrum, if we want to talk about the wavelength, then radio waves is having maximum wavelength. Electromagnetic waves, which are the radio waves region, having maximum wavelength, and electromagnetic waves in the gamma rays region is having minimum wavelength. So wavelength is decreasing from radio waves to gamma rays, or increasing as we shift from gamma rays to radio waves. But in case of frequency or energy, the wavelengths, electromagnetic waves in gamma rays region having highest energy, maximum frequency, and electromagnetic waves in the radio wave region is having minimum energy, lowest frequency. So frequency is increasing from radio wave region to gamma rays region. Radio waves to gamma rays, frequency increases. Ascending order na electromagnetic waves itha arrange zalele from radio waves region to gamma rays region. And as per wavelength, gamma rays region pasun radio waves region parent ascending order wavelength na आपण इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स इथे अरेंज केलेले आहेत. सो ऍज देर आर सेवन मेजर रिजन्स द सोर्सेस दॅट प्रोड्यूस दीज वेव्स, इथं ज्या इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्हचे आपण डिफरंट रिजन्स फॉर्म केलेले आहेत त्या रिजन्स मधील इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स ना प्रोड्यूस करणारे सोर्सेस त्याचबरोबर डिटेक्ट करणारे डिटेक्टर्स आर डिफरंट फॉर डिफरंट रिजन्स. नाउ दीज रिजन्स, दीज सेवन रिजन्स इन इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम have no upper or lower limits, that is sharp boundaries, but all the regions are overlapping. Means that radio waves and microwave, he je don adjacent regions ahet na, that regions are now no sharp boundaries. That means the electromagnetic waves in radio wave region will be in the microwave region. And the electromagnetic waves in microwave region will be in infrared region. That means the seven regions are overlapping. There are no gaps between that regions. So wavelength or frequencies in one region, you will find that wavelength and frequency in another region. That's why according to wavelength, electromagnetic waves in gamma region having the wavelength range 10 raised to minus 13 meter to 10 raised to minus 11 meter. At the same time, electromagnetic waves in X-ray region will have the wavelength range from 10 raised to minus 11 meter to 10 raised to minus 8 meter. Because that regions have no upper or lower limits, that is no sharp boundaries. All the regions are overlapping. Means there are no gaps between that region. So this is about the structure of electromagnetic spectrum. And we come to know that in that electromagnetic spectrum, there are main seven regions. Gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, visible, infrared, microwave and radio waves. And that regions are according to their wavelength range or frequency range. Now, let us go through the detail about their frequency range or wavelength range and the methods of production. So in the first column, we have written the name of that region and there are total seven main regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. We have arranged that region from gamma rays to radio waves. And in this case, the frequency range measured in hertz we have arranged. And if you see that gamma rays to radio waves, what is happening to frequency? The frequency is decreasing up to radio waves. Because for the gamma rays, the electromagnetic waves having the frequency 5 into 10 raised to 20 to 3 into 10 raised to 18. And if you see the order of the frequency, X-rays, ultraviolet, visible light, infrared, microwave, radio wave. Radio waves मध्ये ज्या इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक येतात वेव्स येतात त्यांच्या फ्रिक्वेन्सीची रेंज 5 into 10 raised to 11 to 8 into 10 raised to 10. So if you see the arrangement of that electromagnetic waves from gamma rays to radio waves according to frequency, frequency is decreasing in this order. But if you see the wavelength range of the electromagnetic waves in all the seven regions, then we are finding that wavelength range of electromagnetic waves in gamma rays, gamma region is 6 into 10 raised to minus 13 meter to 1 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. And if you see this order is minus but it is decreasing. And if you find the wavelength of radio waves, wavelength range of radio waves, it is 6 into 10 raised to minus 4 to 1 into 10 raised to 5. So in this case, if we travel from gamma region to radio wave region, the wavelength range increases. Electromagnetic waves in gamma region having shortest wavelength. while electromagnetic waves in a radio wave region is having longest wavelength. So according to ascending order of wavelength, we have arranged, or according to descending order of frequency, we have arranged the electromagnetic waves in that spectrum. Now, the last or fourth column of this table explains how they are produced. Electromagnetic waves in each region, what are the methods of production of them? So here, what is written? Electromagnetic waves in gamma region are produced due to nuclei of atoms of radioactive elements. Means we know that radioactive decay. When nuclei of element of radioactive element undergoes radioactive decay, radioactive transformations, that time alpha, beta and gamma radiations are emitted, particles are emitted. Out of that, that gamma particles are nothing but electromagnetic waves in this gamma region. So electromagnetic waves in gamma region are produced due by nuclei of atoms of radioactive elements. Now, the electromagnetic waves in X-ray region are produced by collision of fast moving electrons on target. The element used for targets must have high atomic number, such as copper element can be used as a target. And when fast moving electron is suddenly stopped by that target, that time electromagnetic waves are emitted, which are called as X-rays. So electromagnetic waves in this X-ray region are produced by collision of fast moving electrons on target. Now, the electromagnetic waves in the ultraviolet region. These electromagnetic waves are produced due to excitation of atoms and molecules. At the same time, sparking also produces electromagnetic waves in the ultraviolet region. Now, this fourth region of electromagnetic spectrum, visible region or visible light. And the electromagnetic waves which are representing this visible region are produced due to excitation of atoms, produced due to spark and arc flame. So these are the sources of electromagnetic waves in visible region. Now, fifth region of electromagnetic spectrum, infrared region. So the electromagnetic waves in infrared region are produced due to excitation of atoms and molecules, but of hot bodies. Those hot bodies having the atoms and molecules, due to their excitation, the electromagnetic waves are produced, and that electromagnetic waves forms infrared region. Now, microwave region. So the electromagnetic waves in the microwave region are produced due to one electronic circuit called as an electronic oscillator, which is parallel combination of inductor and capacitor. So electronic oscillating circuit is the source of microwaves, and radio waves are also produced due to that electronic oscillating circuit. So in this way, this table gives us clear information regarding the electromagnetic spectra, their arrangement, their sequential arrangement according to descending frequency order or according to ascending frequency order is clearly shown in this table. And the last column, fourth column of this table, explaining the methods of production of electromagnetic waves in each region. Now, we will learn the various units used for frequency and wavelength of electromagnetic waves. So, we know that electromagnetic waves, so credit ja hai, production and detection is a credit, hai, that credit goes to Heinrich Hertz. In the year 1988, Heinrich Hertz succeeded in production or producing electromagnetic waves. And also, he succeeded to detect the existence of electromagnetic waves. So, in the memory of that hertz, the SI unit of frequency of electromagnetic waves is named after the scientist hertz. So, SI unit of frequency of electromagnetic wave is called hertz and its symbol is SJ. So, to express high frequencies of electromagnetic waves, we are using here 1 kilohertz. That means 1000 hertz, which is equal to 10 raised to 3 hertz, to express higher frequencies of electromagnetic waves. And if the frequencies are higher than this, then we are using 1 megahertz, which is equal to 10 raised to 6 hertz. And if the frequency is higher than this, then we are using 1 gigahertz, which is equal to 10 raised to 9 hertz. So, kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz are the units used to express high frequencies of electromagnetic waves. Now, we will learn the SI unit of wavelength. As wavelength is the distance, the SI unit of wavelength will be nothing but meter. The SI unit of wavelength of electromagnetic wave is meter. But electromagnetic waves are having very, very small wavelengths. So, to express such small wavelength, this meter is not convenient. So, to express very small wavelengths of electromagnetic waves, we are using here special units. See, first is the micrometer. Micrometer is the small unit of wavelength. And 1 micrometer equal to 10 raised to minus 6 meter. And if the wavelengths are smaller than that, then we are using nanometer. And 1 nanometer equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter. And if the wavelengths of electromagnetic waves are smaller than nanometer, then we are using angstrom unit. So, 1 angstrom unit equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meter or equal to 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter. So, why we are using such small units? Because all the electromagnetic waves which are arranged in the electromagnetic spectrum, they are having very small wavelengths. Though the SI unit of wavelength is meter, but that meter is not convenient unit for the measurement of wavelengths of electromagnetic waves. So, specially this angstrom unit is defined to express the wavelengths of that electromagnetic waves. And you must remember, 1 angstrom is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So, in this way, dear students, we have studied what is electromagnetic spectrum and which are the main regions or main parts of that electromagnetic spectrum. So, with this, we are ending this lecture.